The 20th century represents a significant period. A time of celebration, depression, and of prosperity. A period of destruction and advancement, at times dormant, but usually offering tremendous growth, opportunity, and technological advancement. The 1900s saw significant change.
Red, you go. Where shall I go? What shall I do?
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn.
He's looking at you, kid.
Sit home all alone. If you can't come around, at least please telephone. Don't be cruel to who heart is true. Baby, if I made you mad for something I might have said,
hey, Stella!
And I'm forgetting the past. The future looks bright ahead.
Don't. And so, my fellow Americans, ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country.
I fall to pieces. Each time I see you again,
it's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Just like the rest of the world, the Celco plant experienced far-reaching changes during the 20th century. In 1939, Celco began operations with a workforce of 49 people. The average weekly wage, $13. The product, acetate filament. At the time, Celco owned a vast 1,300 acres of land, extending from Parisburg to Narrows. During the 1940s, a lot of Celco's production was dedicated to the war efforts, since acetate was used to manufacture parachutes. In 1942, the first CA flake and staple were manufactured. During this time, ferry boats were the primary means of transportation to and from the plant. Then, in 1943, roadways and bridges were built, and the Celco bus line was established. Celco also donated 61 acres of land at this time for the Giles County Country Club. Selco and the United Construction Workers signed the first union contract in 1945. The first union president, Sid Ferris. In 48, Selco brought closure to the war era by honoring its 38 employees who gave the ultimate sacrifice. This memorial is still standing today. In 1949, the first wastewater treatment facility was built on the New River. This was the plant's first environmental project. In the 1950s, Selco continued demonstrating its commitment to the surrounding community. 86 acres of land were donated for the Giles Memorial Hospital, 13 acres for the Parisburg Pool and Park, and 114 more to the Country Club. The first acetate tow was manufactured at Selco in the mid-50s. At the time, acetate comprised only 18% of this market. Today, it's close to 100%. In 1956, jet manufacturing moved to Selco. The credit union was also established. And then in 58, Selco sponsored the first ever Christmas party, ensuring every employee's child received a gift at this special time of year. The 1960s represented a time of significant change in American attitudes and social values. This change was reflected at Selco. The United Mine Workers became the new bargaining agent, and in 67, the employees participated in the first and only legal strike, lasting 31 days. In 63, Selco achieved the best safety record in the state of Virginia for a plant of its size. During the 60s, Selco employed over 2,600 workers with an average weekly wage of $92. When America celebrated its birthday in the 70s, Selco celebrated 40 years of production growth. In 1975, cigarette tow operations were expanded, offering new opportunities for business and continued prosperity. However, staple production had declined and was eventually shut down in 1978. Also during the 70s, Selco employees experienced their second union decertification. The textile workers became the third bargaining agent, and they continue representing Selco employees today. The mid-80s offered continued growth and opportunity. The Fibrettes plant began operations in 86, introducing full flexibility throughout its workforce. In 1989, Selco celebrated its 50th anniversary, along with its first 50-year employee, Ott Crawford. The celebration lasted an entire week and was open to employees' families, friends, and the general public. The 90s brought about a change in philosophy, teamwork, and preservation of the environment. Worker involvement and team-based work groups were introduced. Several environmental projects were completed, including Keating, wastewater treatment, and the new landfill. Significant cost reduction goals were established and met without involuntary separations. Today, Selco encompasses 1,300 acres, 20 buildings, and over 1,800 employees. For more than 50 years, we've seen a lot of growth, opportunity, and change. But one piece of the story has remained the same, the spirit of our people. It's this spirit combined with pride, hope, and dedication that's made Selco the prosperous community it is today. We thank each of you for your commitment and honor you for your years of service.
Hello, my name is Roger Booth. I come to work at the Celanese plant in 1960. Along with my work here, I do a little part-time farming, and I am also into the ministry, have been for the last 10 years, which I find very rewarding in my time off, and just giving God thanks for the help He's given me to work here this many years, and look forward to continuing to be able to work, if health will permit, for 10 to 15 years, and that would put me at retirement age.
Hello, my name is J.C. Kyle. I'm a boiler operator at Selco. I've been with the company for 30 years. I hired in 1966 in spinning, which they call extrusion. I worked 11 years in extrusion, and I've been in the boiler house for 19 years. And I'd like to take this opportunity while I have the chance to thank Celanese for supplying me with a job for the last 30 years. I appreciate it very much.
My name is Lee King. I've been here at Celanese. It'll be 30 years, June the 21st. I've been in number one building for 30 years. I enjoyed my 30 years here, and I enjoy working with the people, and I hope to retire within 7 or 8 years, if possible.
Hello, I'm Roger Comer. I've worked here at Celco for 30 years. I started on July the 19th, 1966. Let me say that was a great day for me. And I worked in the extrusion department just about the whole time, except I worked CC manufacturing one time for about 5 months. But I work as an inspector in extrusion now. And let me say that I've enjoyed working at Celco, made a lot of friends over the years, hope to make a lot more, hope to get at least a few more years in here.
My name's Yvonne Ball, and I work in Staples, and I'm a catwalk operator. I've worked at the Celanese for about 30 years. I enjoy working with the Celanese, and especially the opportunity that I've had to work with a great group of people. They've all been very good to me. When I came to Staples, it's like coming to a different world because the work is so different over here. I've had been challenged to do the work of a lot of different jobs, and I've enjoyed it, and I like my job that I do now as a catwalk operator, and the people that I work with are real good. I'm looking forward to the day that I can retire and be with my family.
My name is Marion Campbell. I work in extrusion tow. I've been with Celanese. I started with Celanese 6366. Enjoy working with the people and the company.
My name is James Evans. Everybody calls me Jim. I've been here 30 years. It's 9 years of welding shop, other than CC shop. I've enjoyed working with a lot of the fellas and looking forward to retirement.
Hello, I'm William Purdy. I've been with the company 35 years. My heart is in the bottom store is 61. Been 6 years in the bottom store. I've been at New Chelsea for the last 29 years. I enjoy working the personality. I enjoy the hourly pay. I enjoy working for the staff and office. It's really been a pleasure for the last 35 years to be employed by the Hoechst Corporation.
Hi, I'm Ellen Cano. I've worked in spinning for 35 years. I came here in May of 61. I've worked TL crew, and I have enjoyed working here, and it's been a good job.
My name's David Martin. Worked at Celanese 30 years. Work out Bill Engineering, signed to CC Manufacturing. Got 6 more years to retire and looking forward to it and enjoyed working with everybody. Thank you.
I'm Lola Lindsay. I've worked at Celco for 35 years. I started out in 1961 carrying the mail, and then I went to CA Manufacturing and to Employee Relations, and then I ended up in the Safety and Medical Department. And since I've worked 35 years, I plan on retiring August 1st, 1996, and I'm really looking forward to it.
Gotcha. I'm Dave Lloyd, and I've been at Celco Plant for 35 years, nearly 10 of those last years in the filament department. If you get up at 30 to 35,000 feet and look down, Celco is indeed the largest community in the surrounding area, certainly in the Giles County area. Lots of communities would do anything to have something like we have here, and it's been a good place for us to work. It will continue to be a good place for us to work as long as we take care of it and nurture it and give it what it needs and deserves to stay a healthy business and a healthy organization. I consider it indeed a privilege to have been a part of doing that in the last 35 years.
My name is Roy Whitaker.
I come down to the Celanese to work in 3rd of May of 66. And I had 30 years in 3rd day of May this year. And I have enjoyed every bit of the years I've worked for Celco. I've had no problems. I think a good company to work for, and I appreciated my job and for 30 years, and I wish I had about 30 more to work. I went for as high as 13, 14 years without missing a day's work. I really enjoyed it.
I'm Don Janelle. I started working at Celco in 1961, May 22nd. Department and later being in the CC department. Been here ever since. I worked as an operator throughout the plant for the last 2 years, through the CC manufacturer rather. And in the last 2 years I've been unloading wood pulp. Everything is getting more complicated, but although it provides a good job for people in this area.
I'm James Akers, and I come to Celanese in 1966, and I had 3 weeks work on the job I started on, which is the janitor here, and I've been here 30 years, and when I get that 3 weeks work done, I think I'll quit. But I've enjoyed working here, and I've made a good living here, and I've enjoyed it, and I've enjoyed working with people here in CA department, and I'll be glad when I can retire and sit back and let somebody else do the work.
I'm Linda Lefford. I'm a first-line supervisor in the quality assurance labs. I came to work at Celco in February of 1983. I started to work at the Greenville plant on December the 13th, 1965. I've enjoyed my year's service with Hoechst Celanese and the Celanese Corporation. And when I started to work at 19, I never dreamed I would be working for 30 years in the same place.
My name is Mildred Popp, and I work in the beaming department as supervisor on A shift, and I have been here 30 years as of May the 13th, and I started out as an operator in beaming, and moved up to a supervisor, and I have worked as supervisors in coning, twisting, and now I'm back in beaming, and I really enjoy working in beaming. I have a nice group of people to work with, and I very much enjoy working with them.
I'm Patricia Martin. I work in the beaming department. I've been here for 30 years. Was hired in May the 13th, 1966. I've spent my entire 30 years here in beaming. I'm married to Joe Martin, and we live in Nares, Virginia. Have one daughter, Kimberly. She has two boys, and they now reside in Orlando, Florida. I've enjoyed working here at the Celco and hope I have a good many more years.
I'm Jean Ross. I've worked in beaming for the last 30 years. I was hired in May the 13th, 1966, along with Mildred Popp, Patty Martin, and Yvonne Ball that are still presently working at Celco. I won't be able to attend the awards dinner this year because I'm working 3-11, but I'd like to congratulate all my cohorts and everyone that's celebrating this occasion.
Yeah.
needing other children. And yet letting a grown-up pride hide all the need inside, acting more like children than children. Lovers are very special people. One very special person, a feeling deep in your soul says you are half, now you're whole. No more hunger and thirst, but first be a person who needs people. People who need people are the luckiest people in the world. With one person, one very special person, a feeling deep in your soul says you are half, now you're whole. No more hunger and thirst, but first be a person who needs people.
Thank you.